Hello there, it's Ethan here. I'm having a lot of fun with the new Stray release on the Mac, and I'm just going to do a quick video here comparing the built-in temporal upscaling, which is the same that's on other releases of Stray on other platforms, and the MetalFX, which is exclusive, obviously, to this Mac release. When I was playing it initially, I noticed that you could get 60 FPS, at least on my machine, which the specs will be in the description below, with 50% scaling, so half resolution input before MetalFX. And with the temporal upscaling, I could get to 60%, so a higher resolution. Obviously, MetalFX is doing something more complicated, so it needs a bit more processing overhead to complete that. So I asked the question, is the higher input resolution going to result in maybe a better picture quality? Is it worth this extra performance overhead? And the short answer is, I don't think it is, at least for this game. I'd recommend that anybody use the built-in scaler for reasons I'll get into. But first of all, a quick settings tip that I think some people might look over for anybody playing on a built-in display. This game is only supported by the M-series chips, and anybody using one of those Macs is going to have a very high resolution screen that runs by default in what's called high DPI mode. And this means that the resolution reported by the OS to the game is half of the actual resolution of your screen. And that means that it runs at that resolution and then does some pretty poor scaling to then display at the deep resolution of the screen. So what I recommend you do is change from borderless to exclusive mode, and then set the resolution to whatever the actual resolution of your Mac's internal display is. Here I've put the 1610 resolution of my Mac, so that's without the notch at the top. And then use the internal scaler to set it to whatever resolution you need to do to hit the performance target that you want. Maybe use a 30 frame per second cap if you're on a MacBook Air, one of the fanless models. It might look like a subtle difference, especially on YouTube, but it is quite a bit cleaner, basically for no penalty. A lot of Mac releases have this problem, so I'd say this is an Apple problem rather than a developer problem, but at least there aren't any external tools that are needed to resolve it in this case. Okay, so comparing this opening cutscene, one of the ones that isn't pre-rendered, we can see that we're below 48 frames per second, and that's acceptable for me because in general gameplay it's at 60, but these cutscenes are a little bit harder. And what you'll notice is that the fur in the MetalFX is a bit less temporally stable and looks a bit furrier as well, but I don't think it looks nicer. You see this flicker, and I think it doesn't look as good. It's a perfectly good solution, but not better than the one that's already in the game, which also is what the game's art have been designed with, so best to keep that one on, I think. But I was looking for places where the MetalFX did have an advantage, and that was some instances on fast movement. This place where the cat jumps backwards, you can see that dark area still persisting once the cat is no longer there, or when it does this fast scratch with its foot there. And you can see a trail on the temporal upscaling as well. But generally speaking, I would say there's not a reason to keep MetalFX instead, apart from curiosity. It just looks better and is more stable, and also is more performant with the temporal upscaling. You'll also see that the captures are going out of sync with each other here, and that's because the MetalFX version is keeping a frame in hold every time there's a camera cut. The developer must have had another solution for this with the temporal anti-aliasing. You also have a bit of a bug I noticed, this fringing that sometimes appears at the bottom of the screen, and that's in both modes, so you can't really avoid that yet, but hopefully that gets fixed. I don't know if that's in other versions of the game as well, but that's basically it. I would say keep temporal upscaling on, and it's a good game. Go buy it.